There's this story that has profoundly impacted my life, and I've just been thinking on it a lot here as of recently. It's this story of these people standing around in a circle. They're talking to each other, and these people have a high view of moral perfectionism, of looking absolutely flawless, of showing no one that they have any weaknesses in their life. And as they're standing there, they're watching, and this leader comes to town. He's supposed to be this like profound leader, and this leader is spending time with the people who are the farthest away from perfect. They are the thieves, they are the liars, they're the drug addicts, they're the prostitutes. And these people standing around in the circle watching this leader converse and spend time with these people who are so far from perfect, they cannot understand what is taking place. And this leader stands up and he tells them, "Those who are well have no need for a physician, but those who are sick do." And so he's making this point that these perfect people, they live under this facade that they have it all figured it out. They have no need for anyone to help them. They have no room for a prescription from a physician to help them to grow, because in their mind, they're already perfect. However, the people who are messed up, the people who knew their imperfections, they are the ones who could receive help from this physician. This is a true story. It's a conversation that actually took place in the Gospels, where Jesus is talking to the Pharisees. He followed these comments by saying, "I come not to call the righteous, but to call the sinners." My name is Ben Ramos, and I get the privilege of serving as the senior pastor at Rise Church here in Idaho Falls. I'm a pastor, but I used to be a drug addict. I'm a pastor, but I'm still messed up. Seriously, like, I say the wrong things, I wear the wrong things, I feel like I don't fit in sometimes, and so often I feel like I'm such a mess. But I'm finally a part of a church family where feeling different and being imperfect is normal. If you're looking for a place where you can be imperfect, a place where you can still be a little bit broken, a place where you can still be a little bit different, a little bit messed up, you might just be able to call this your church home. The good news of Jesus Christ is not that he saved you so now you can be absolutely perfect. It's about recognizing that you're not perfect and that you need him to help you to grow. It's in this place where you can actually begin to heal from life's hurts. It's in this place where you can feel the weight of trying to be perfect removed, so you can actually take steps forward in your life. It's in this place where you can know for real that God exists and that he wants to live with you in your life on a day-to-day basis. It's in this place where you can find true transformation. So if you've been hurt by religion or religious people, if you are lost and you don't know where to go, if you've felt like you could never fit into a church, if you are sick and you need to be healed, if you need a miracle, if you need direction, if you're searching for more, if you need help, if you need inspiration, if you need friends and you need to feel known and need to be seen, if your kids need a safe place to make good friends, if you feel like you're just imperfect, well, we might be the perfect place for your imperfect self, because we're imperfect too. I'd love to invite you to our Easter service on Sunday, April 17th at 10 a.m. at Rise Church. We're on 2nd and Holmes, across the street from Leo's place. We will have the welcoming crews here and ready to greet you. I'd love to see you then.